Alles. Shootout. 11.
Jonathan Huberto.
No goal. Didn't have much in the way of creativity there as he gets shut down. Makes the move and scores! I really like the way he executed this deke. He froze the goalie and takes it around him to score. And he makes it look easy on the play. Just like they do in practice. Stop just what the shooter has to offer. Gives them absolutely nothing. I think the goalies that are best at this are the ones that are the most efficient. They don't move a whole lot. They just... He scores! Gives them absolutely nothing on that. It's amazing how many points are alive in a season. The goalie has to be good if you're going to collect some of them. Absolutely nothing doing on that. Sometimes you make a move, sometimes you choose to shoot, and there's just nothing there.
Next shooter for the Bruins, number 37, Patrice Bergeron.
Makes it look easy on the play there, eh? I think it's harder for the goalie in the shootout than it would be on a breakaway.
Really?
Shooter has so much more time.
Next shooter for the Panthers, number 74, Owen Tippett.
Scores! Oh, what a snipe! Didn't have much room. It looked like the goalie was in pretty good shape. But this one's in the back of the net.
David Krejci.
Puts it in, they will play on! Oh, cold-blooded right there. Pressure is on him. He had to score, and the shootout will now continue. Advantage goalie on that.
Yeah, there's no dice. I got a good view of it, and there's just nowhere to shoot the puck.
And he scores! That's it! What's the old expression?
You can take a horse to water?
No, no. Winner, winner, chicken. center ice. He's ready to get this thing underway. Jonathan. Big save. Pasternak at center ice with the mindset, anything you can do, I can do better. He scores! Sweet dangle!
Really great move, James. He fakes the goaltender down and out of the play to put it away. He really sold this move on the goaltender who bit hard. Then he was able to put it inside the post.
And it scores!
Great hands here. He fakes the goaltender, holds it with patience, and then finishes it off.
You're fine with the shot there. Off the crossbar! What an opportunity right there!
Number 63, Brad Marchand.
Scores! Good night!
Coach has him at the end. Got a lot of faith in him, and he rewards him with a nice goal to wrap this up.
And that puts a bow on this one. It needed a...
NHL Super Agent Taylor Mackey joins us here on the line, who represents the hottest, most anticipated prospect in years. Taylor, give us the 411 on the kid here.
Hey, morning, James. Well, look, you may not believe this, but the kid's up here on Carter Lake.
What?
Playing pickup, yeah, with a bunch of other kids. Just, it's a beautiful day.
Pricey pond hockey you got going there.
Yeah, I suppose it is. But look, that's how much this kid loves the game, man.
Well, just safety first up there. Now,
of course,
I got to ask you, we've seen the scouting reports, we've seen the highlights, but we know about the player. But tell me more about the person. What's this rookie really like?
Yeah, sure, James. Let's begin by telling your listeners at home the kid's name.
With the Champions League set to get underway here in the not-too-distant future, what an opportunity for so many players. And never mind the veterans that might be eyeballing a chance to get back or trying to get to the National Hockey League across the seas. How about as a youngster? I mean, scouts love youth. Management loves youth. And what an opportunity to shine. If you can fit, if you can have some success in this tournament, boy, this could really bode well for your hockey future and really pay off financially as well if you can have a strong showing. All right, we're going to break down, look at some of these teams that are involved in some of the head-to-head matchups, and we'll do that in a moment. So here we go. When you look at the opportunities that present itself here for so many teams chasing the Champions League title, you know, how about from a youngster standpoint, for a kid who might be draft eligible? This is playing in a tournament against grown-ups, against men. You have a strong tournament, your draft stock could go through the roof and really hit a home run financially and move up those draft rankings. We'll take a look at some of those key names to watch here. Our draft analyst is going to drop by a little later on in the show. How about that performance from the kid between the pipes? I mean, you talk about locking it down and a league against grown-ups. That's the impressive thing. When you look at young players and they thrive in these situations, you know, you look at the maturity where some of these veterans who may have been playing pro sports or playing pro hockey for 20 years, this kid steps on the scene and puts up a performance like that in the Champions League. Absolutely impressive in my books. All right, elsewhere in football, a couple of big games to look ahead to. Along with Ray Ferraro, I'm James Cebulski. Welcome back, everyone, and buckle up while you're at it, because this should be a doozy here this evening. It was a dead heat in game one, second leg. This is where we find out who's going to walk away with it.
We're not going home tonight until we know who goes on from this series. The aggregate scoring is at zero, and now this game means everything.
We are just seconds away now from puck drop. The Devils take possession here on the opening draw, and we are underway. And he takes a shot, and that one's stopped.
A defenseman loves this. The puck doesn't stay in front of the net. It's now in the corner.
A quick one here, and look at this, the first goal of the game.
Man, I don't even think anyone's really settled into the game yet. And already we have the game's first goal.
You've got to get rid of that puck in a hurry from that spot on the ice. You're in the high slot, you're open, but you know everybody's converging on you.
Lots of time left in this period. Poyens wins the draw in the neutral zone.
By number 37.
Moves the puck along the half wall. Here's a shot, and too much traffic in front blocks that one.
52 seconds.
Through center along the wing. They've got the defense outnumbered. Stopped by the goaltender. Takes the pass. Looks to set up at the point now. The lane was plugged up and that shot's blocked. Puts it on net. Nothing doing.
Hit the net. No chance to score if you don't get the puck on target.
Poyens moves it quickly along the wing. Here's a short pass to Brown. Denies it in front. Poyens on the attack. Here's a shot. Glove save. And an easy one at that. Cardiff's got the puck in the defensive end. Here they are on the attack. Takes a wrist shot. Oh, and comes up with nothing on the play. Oh, just wide of the net.
From my angle, that looked like it was going in. He just misses that wide. Like the way that they've hunted the...
Scores! That's two unanswered now.
They stayed right on it. Once they got that first one, they just pushed the pace of this. Now they get another.
When you get into this position, that puck's got to be off your stick in a hurry. You don't have much time to think about it.
Still a lot of time left in the period as we approach the midway mark. Cardiff's won it from the neutral zone now. Cardiff's got it along the wall. Centering pass. He scores. Well, it rains and pours.
And they are just coming out in buckets right now as they get three straight. Really a dominating performance.
Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Takes the feed from the left side. Shot being stopped by the goaltender right in front.
Sharp reaction save.
The Devils get a hold of the puck along the boards. Gives them nothing in front. Taken along the wall by Little. Poyens plays it along the wall. On the attack along the boards. Quick pass to Little. Off the glove. Picked up along the boards by Eller. And now he tries to get it across to Little. Let's it go. And he comes up with it. Grabs the puck here inside the offensive end. Stones him in front. The Devils take it along the wing. He almost lost it for a second there, but regains control of the puck. Stopped by the goaltender. Slides it back to the blue line. Nothing doing on that. Here he is in front, right in the slot, and he gets a paddle on that one.
Yeah,
scores! He stayed with it and buries the rebound.
That's a good play. It's a goal scorer's play. You shoot the puck and follow your shot. He gets a little lucky that it comes right back to him, but he makes no mistake.
The Devils are dominating in almost every facet of the game here in the first. This neutral zone faceoff set to go, and we are back underway. From against the wall, it's centered out. And he makes the save. Through the neutral zone, moving the puck along the side. Here's an odd man rush. Sends it over. Stopped by the goaltender.
Dead center. Excellent save.
Denies him again.
Really sharp. Never loses sight of the puck to make the second save.
And look at this coming out of his crease to challenge.
Everybody wants to see the goalie go all the way down the challenge. It never happens.
Now, two guys at opposite ends of the ice can get to this point, but the crowd seems to love it.
This, James, is peer pressure.
Puck set to drop. We've got some 4-on-4 coming up.
This is the time, James, you get your skill guys into the game more frequently. 4-on-4 is open ice. It's danger if you have skill. And the team with the most skill is probably going to be the best.
Off the outside of the iron and we'll play on. Past the midway mark of the frame, James and Ray with you tonight. Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Turns it away. The Devils came hungry to play this one, and they lead as a result here in the first. Offensive zone faceoff, and he wins the draw. Stopped by the goaltender. Little's got it in the defensive end. Looking to set up offensively. Takes the feed. Locks it down. He scores! Jumps all over his rebound and puts it in.
Once his puck bounces off the goaltender the first time, the shooter's the next guy in position. The D can't turn quick enough, and he puts it away into the net.
The Devils have had way more chances offensively, and as a result, they're leading in this one. And play resumes as the puck is dropped.
Scored by number 24, assisted by number 6.
Let's it go from the slot. Misses high.
That feels like a wasted opportunity. You got to get it on target.
Might have skipped up on him right before he let it go. Here's a chance to his teammate. Let's it fly, and that one's turned away. Hoyens gains a hold of possession. Sends a pass over. Here's a shot. He scores!
Now you just stop thinking about the first goal. Now you got another. That's 30 seconds apart.
We are not done yet here. Buckle up. Don't even think about leaving your seat.
Yeah, they got their track shoes on now. He drops into the butterfly to try and take away as much of the net as he can. But the shooter's got enough time to find some room. He sees it, and he doesn't miss.
The centermen glide into position. Face-off here in the neutral zone, and we are back underway.
Number 9, Ken Brown, assisted by number 24.
Moves it quickly over to Riley. Handles the puck. Drives to the crease. Oh, pokes it away. Gutsy move, but it pays off. Over the line they come. Moves it to Little. Can't catch up to the pass. And uses the length of his stick to knock that puck away. His reflexes on display tonight. Here he is in close. He scores! That's 3 in a row!
This is turning into an onslaught. There seems to be no way to slow them down.
Past the midway mark in this period. Cardiff's won the draw in the neutral zone.
Scored by number 57, assisted by number...
A chance right in front, nothing!
Oh man, he's frustrated with himself. He's got to get that on the net.
Here in the late goings of the period. The Devils win it. Slides the puck over. Oh, denies him with the save! I think he got the blocker on it! The Devils lead it here late in this first period. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Sends the pass over. Hoyens plays the puck along the boards. Blocked in traffic. Nice pass. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Riley. Quick shot. Comes up with the stop. There's the whistle as things will slow down here for a moment.
Always a good play if you're not sure what's going on. Freeze the...
NHL Super Agent Taylor Mackey joins us here on the line, who represents the hottest, most anticipated prospect in years. Taylor, give us the 411 on the kid here.
Hey, morning, James. Well, look, you may not believe this, but the kid's up here on Carter Lake.
What?
Playing pickup, yeah, with a bunch of other kids. It's a beautiful day.
Pricey pond hockey you got going there.
Yeah, I suppose it is. But look, that's how much this kid loves the game, man.
Well, just safety first up. I got to ask you, we've seen the scouting reports, we've seen the highlights, but we know about the player. But tell me more about the person. What's this rookie really like?
Yeah, sure, James. Let's begin by telling your listeners at home the kid's name.
With the Champions League set to get underway here in the not-too-distant future, what an opportunity for so many players. And never mind the veterans that might be eyeballing a chance to get back or trying to get to the National Hockey League across the seas. How about as a youngster? I mean, scouts love youth. Management loves youth. And what an opportunity to shine. If you can fit, if you can have some success in this tournament, boy, this could really bode well for your hockey future and really pay off financially as well if you can have a strong showing. All right, we're going to break down, look at some of these teams that are involved in some of the head-to-head matchups, and we'll do that in a moment. here we go. When you look at the opportunities that present itself here for so many teams chasing the Champions League title, you know, how about from a youngster standpoint, for a kid who might be draft eligible? This is playing in a tournament against grown-ups, against men. You have a strong tournament, your draft stock could go through the roof and really hit a home run financially and move up those draft rankings. We'll take a look at some of those key names to watch here. Our draft analyst is going to drop by a little later on in the show. Welcome back to EA Sports. He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski, getting set to call all the action here. Ray, it's a Champions League showdown we've got tonight.
Different teams from different countries bring their style of play in a true tournament format. I love the way that there was so much unfamiliarity between the teams.
And we are about set to drop the puck on this one. Lots of time left in this period. The Eagles lead it 1-0. And sneaks in and grabs possession. Oh, and he tracks it perfectly in the offensive end. Now he takes it over the line. And he's going after him here. Tension's rising.
Didn't take much to get this heated up.
Well, that didn't take long.
Yeah, early in the game, looks like each team trying to get an upper hand.
And down he goes.
That's a clear winner right there. That's one way to put a cap on the emotion that's starting to run in this game. You kick the guys out that fight. That'll help keep a lid on things.
Everybody on their feet in the arena, but they'll say goodnight after that exchange. From center, they get into the attacking area. Lets it go. Gets in front of it. Moves the puck. Into the offensive zone. Hammers a shot, and he stands tall in goal. Lukos across the blue line. Great poke check on the reach. And the puck is cleared to a safer spot. Rauma's gained possession along the boards. Through the neutral zone now, picking up steam. Takes it to the net. Here's a shot with the stop. Tries to get it out of their own end. And it's a small victory for the PK unit here.
Well, that's their job. Get it down the ice. Get off the ice. Get some new people out there.
Rauma's in transition. And he regains control of the puck. Mannheim's penalty killers get a hold of it. Nice zone entry from the middle. Here's a chance. That goes off a twig. Shinneman's working it around in the corner. And that's out of reach and out of the offensive zone. Mannheim's back to even strength as they've killed off the penalty.
You work so hard to get...
Here he is on a breakaway. Scores! Talk about living up to the hype.
Lots of talk from people that really hadn't seen this guy play. Hey, he's a goal scorer. He can really fill the net. Well, it didn't take him long, did it? He's on the board.
Mannheim's got it in their own zone. Handles the pass in the middle. To the front! Knocks it away with the paddle. Great poke check. Gets it out of his own end. Let's bring in our own Carlin Bade, who's got the latest on social media. What are you seeing out there?
Thanks, James. You know, you're...
Scores! That's how you trot up with the extra attacker.
Well, you've got the extra man, so you want to move the puck more quickly. You want to retrieve it. With greater numbers, they do it all well, and they're on the board.
Killers make a mistake, they give up a man advantage break. And the power play doesn't miss. With the extra man, they score on the rush.
The Eagles win possession here in the open ice. From the left side into the middle of the neutral zone.
Dahls frightens the other team as soon as he collects the puck here. He's got two. He's looking for a hat trick. Oh, that's going to be a penalty. They're going to have to call that.
Officials blowing the play dead. We've got a penalty on the way here. The Eagles will serve 2 minutes in the box. Played with fire. He got burned, Ray.
He's digging around for the puck, and sometimes you just get caught. This time the player goes down, and he's got to go to the box.
Stopped by the goaltender. Puck moved back to the neutral zone. Rauma's got control of it now from their own end. Along the side, here they come through the neutral zone. Handles it along the blue line. Stopped by the goaltender. And another stop. Puck is cleared out of the defensive zone. Here's the chance to set up now. Great use of the body to knock him off the puck. Hard hit on the play.
Wow, did he ever finish him hard. And when he dropped, he also dropped his stick. Now he's got to collect himself. Looks like a yard sale out there.
Let it go. That's off a stick. He was locked in there. Cuts to the front. Misses a golden opportunity there.
Now he's got to get that on target. That's a scoring chance, and he doesn't even make the goaltender make a save.
Trying to clear. Call that a win for the penalty killers on that one.
Yeah, he slams it off the glass. Now the power play's got to go back to get set up.
Rauma's playing it through center. Mannheim's got it into the offensive zone. Along the half wall with the puck. Takes the feed. Rauma's looking to break out of their own end. Looks like we got a delayed tripping penalty coming up here. And the officials will pass the sentence here.
So often in a shifty little play, you're trying to get to the puck, you get your stick in the wrong spot, he steps on your stick, and there's nothing you can do.
Luco's got a small window with a 5-on-3.
This is going to be quick, this 5-on-3, but if you can win the draw, you should be able to get a quick shot.
Here in the late goings of the period, the Eagles have dominated this one to this point. They lead it 3-0. Rome has won the draw, and they'll go to work. Both sides are evened up as the power play has expired.
A lot of head shaking on the bench when you go back after a power play like that. Well executed, lots of pressure, just couldn't finish.
Rauma's down despite numerous scoring opportunities here late in the first. Luco's got it, and they're on the attack.
Now you got a chance to make something against a tired team.
And a stick in the lane ends that threat. Mannheim's got it across the line. Breakaway, and scores!
You get one, you want to think about a second one. It doesn't matter if you're at home or on the road. When you do this on the road, you feel a great accomplishment.
And there's the one hat that he gets for scoring on the road.
Some guys like to shoot, some guys like to deke. You can shoot the puck like that on a breakaway. I'd pick that as option A.
The setters will glide into the dot. Mannheim's won the draw. Receives the pass. Here he is on the backhand. He gets a piece of it with a stick.
Aggressive stop out on top of the crease to make the save on a dangerous chance.
Long reach breaks up the momentum. First period almost in the books here, nearing the final 60 seconds. And they score. Luco's won the draw, and they take possession here in the open ice. Takes the pass. Luco's got the puck against the half wall. Wide of the net.
He's got to do something a little better than that. Just can't finish it from there.
Wonder if that gives him a nightmare later. Nice defensive robbery with the stick. The first period in the books, and not a moment too soon. What a performance. At least at one end.
If you are the holder of the winning ticket, please take it to our customer service kiosk.
Rauma's going to squish things up between the pipes.
You ever wonder in a blowout why the goalie leaving skates way faster than the guy coming in?
Set to get underway here in the second period. We'll see if they can stop the bleeding. Moves around along the half wall. Big save.
Certain saves are more difficult than others. This one right from the slot is turned aside.
Takes it to the front. Puts it off the outside of the frame. And that goes off the post and out.
Latinen's done nice work here on this scoring chance to turn it aside.
They continue to preserve the lead. Ray Ferraro, it looks like the coach is sending a message out there.
Yeah, the message is safety first. They want that puck forward. They don't want any creative plays, really, that there's a chance you could turn it over. And he's reminding the youngest player, which is always a good thing to do.
Still early on in this frame, James and Ray with you. So glad you could join us. Mannheim's put on a smothering offensive performance. They lead it 5-0. Gets control of the puck here in his own end. Rauma's got it against the boards. They've got numbers. Takes a shot. Oh, lot of jaw back and forth here.
Is there ever? I mean, the guys look like they're pretty agitated. Dolls is looking for somebody to engage in a fight with. He can't find the right guy.
Looks like they're going to whistle him for unsportsmanlike here.
That's a tough one to take. This one really burns at your coach. This is one that never goes in the category of a good penalty.
This is one that coaches would hate, wouldn't they?
Yeah, they don't like this at all. Well, neither do your teammates. It feels like a penalty that you don't have to kill.
Realm has had the scoring opportunities. They just haven't been able to capitalize as they continue to trail. Back underway as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Answered the call on that play.
Endros has shown tremendous focus. He's got a great save percentage in this contest. And at the other end, his forwards are helping him out.
Takes the feed. A little back and forth. Drives to the sweet spot. Oh, and he can thank his stick for that one. Here he is in front. Being stopped by the keeper. Raumas look good offensively to this point, but they continue to trail here in the second. Lukos got it in the offensive zone. Rocked him in the open ice. Glove save! Oh, quick reflexes on the play! From the left side, they enter the offensive zone. Grabs the puck at center. Here's a shot denied by the goaltender. Wraps it.
That's close, James. The goaltender ends up beating the shooter to the post. That looks like it's a goal, but it's shut down.
Getting closer to the halfway point of this frame. A quick look at the scoreboard. It's too much to not enough. 5-0. Along the wing, up the neutral zone. Sends a pass over. Stick save! The Eagles move the puck in the defensive zone. All alone! Huge stop by the goaltender.
Oh, he read that perfectly. Excellent position to make the stop on the breakaway.
Penalty has expired. You got to give this. And he scores! The Eagles' offense on full display tonight. What impressed you the most?
Well, the varied way that they score. I mean, they have just dominated this game. I love the way that they've attacked the net.
Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. And that one's broken up. Great block there. From the point. Oh, he stops it with a glove. Great reflexes there. Play set to resume with the faceoff ready to go. Dolls is quick on the draw. Quick feed to Desjardins. Blast from the blue line. Oh, he comes up with a stop as he got the glove on it. Takes a shot and rings the iron.
The Eagles maybe can put that in their pocket and save it for another night. They're up big here and thoroughly in control.
Tempers flaring.
Yeah, a little bump together, a little friction. Looks like the guys want to get it going. Dolls is roaming around looking for somebody else to fight. He just can't find it.
Well, things should open up for both sides here with a little four-on-four action. And a good read to get possession there with the two centermen tangled up. Makes the stop with the blocker. There's the horn ending period number two. I'm not sure they wanted it to end.
It's time to support those around us with our monthly food drive. Bring it.
The official's made his way to center, and this third period is about to go. Here we go, third period set to get underway. Simply too much to not enough at this point. Ray Ferraro is back down at ice level. Ray, 40 minutes played so far. What's been your assessment of this tilt?
Mannheim's focus now is just locked down this game. Comfortable lead. They've been terrific through 40 minutes. Don't give it away now.
And the power play unit comes up empty on that one. The Eagles have it against the wall and couldn't find the intended receiver on that one. Lukos got the puck inside the defensive zone. Tries to make that cross-ice feed. Looking to make something happen along the boards. Takes control of the puck. Sends the pass over. Cutting to the slot. Rauma's got the puck. The whack, but still hangs on. Gains the zone through center. Here he is, wristed on net. Denies it in front. Endres hangs on for the whistle, and a much-needed one, I would say, Ray.
He's been busy since the first period, but he's been excellent. I like the way he's controlled the rebounds, the way that he's given his team a chance. It's been an outstanding night for him.
Fails to find the open man. Dahls plays the puck. Quick shot. He scores!
Pretty bold play to get out and score a shorthanded goal. You really pushed the other team backwards with this marker. Absolutely powders this thing. The goalie doesn't really have a chance. The rookie's had a really good game, and he gets a little tap from the coach as he comes back to the bench. That doesn't happen very often. Pretty satisfying when you know the boss is happy with you.
We've called his name multiple times. He's been all over the ice tonight. The Eagles have put in a complete team effort tonight, but they've really looked good offensively.
Their arms are going to be tired from all the times they've had them up in the air here. This has been a dominating offensive performance.
No kidding.
Steps into it, and that goes off a player. Turn that chance aside, and pokes the puck loose inside the offensive end. Smart defensive play there. Rauma's on the attack. Takes that pass back at the point. Gives them nothing in front. Endres is going to take the opportunity for a whistle.
He's been outstanding tonight, James. It doesn't seem to matter what shot has come at him. He's been able to handle it, and he's had plenty of work.
Handles the puck. Sends the cross-ice pass. And that one's picked off in the neutral zone. Lukos on the attack. Uses the force on that hit.
Well, that didn't look very good. After that hit, he just stayed on the ice, not really moving very much.
He scores! Jumps on the rebound and makes it count!
Mannheim's having a lot of fun out there tonight, but Ray, I can imagine it's a different story on the other side of the bench.
Yeah, half the guys out here are having fun. The other half, this game can't end quick enough.
At center ice now, he grabs the puck. 24. Quick shot, and it comes up with the save. Centered out in front. Again, the denial by the goaltender.
Quick reflexes. You make one, you make two stops before the puck is cleared away.
Mannheim's gained possession. From the defensive zone, they move the puck around. They've got the defense outnumbered. Puts it on net. He scores! This might be a where-were-you moment for so many of these fans.
Man,
Again, he gets a chance on goal, and he makes no mistake about it.
Mannheim's got a hold of the puck off the draw. Nice pass. Here he is, shot right in front, and puts it just wide.
The goalie was late reacting. If that puck hits the net, I think it's in.
Moves it up through the middle for the right. And he uses his reach to disrupt the play. Tried to make a move, and the puck hops away. Gets the full use of his stick on the poke check. Mannheim's got a hold of the puck. Lukko's got a hold of it against the wall. Right to the middle. Puts one on net. Turned aside with a glove. Wrist one in close. And that one's blocked. Mannheim's in now. Here he is with the backhander. He scores! Unbelievable, Ray. Are we watching something historical tonight?
It's not over yet. There seems like there's more chances in it for him. Now that's a goal scorer's goal right there, James. He establishes position low in the slot and zips the backhander past the goalie.
Officials getting ready to drop the puck. Puck possession so key in today's game.
And that's all she wrote from this one here tonight. Well, do we bother showing up for leg two?
Yeah, there's an invoice there, James. We're going to be there.
But
unless those guys stub their toe badly here, this should be their...
Champions League's officially underway, game number one in the books, and look at this youngster who there are a lot of eyes, there was a lot of hype, and getting a lot of buzz from a draft stock standpoint. And I'll tell you what, if he continues to play like this throughout the tournament, his stock will go through the roof. And keep in mind, here's the difference for kids playing junior back in North America. Now, thank you.
Hi, everyone. I'm James Cebulski along with Ray Ferraro here on the EA Sports Broadcast Crew, ready to bring you a fun one tonight. A huge lead going into this one, but we've seen crazier things happen in aggregate series and other sports.
Absolutely so, and even though they're way down in the series, I would expect them to come out, have defense rushing up into the plate. They need goals and lots of them.
Lots of time left in this period. Mannheim's won it. Grabs the puck here in the neutral zone. Driving right to the front. Made the save on the play.
I like how he was able to follow the puck. Good save in close.
Linus takes it across the line. Pokes it away in his own end. Lukos got the puck against the boards. Good defensive effort to poke it away. One-on-one with the goaltender. What a stop by the goaltender.
Hey, he was able to gauge his speed against the skaters. He moved back nicely with them to make the stop. Oh, look at that. Here we go. We got a penalty coming up right here.
We've got a penalty coming up on the play. The Eagles are going to serve two for tripping here.
Reaches in with his stick and gets nabbed for the trip.
And their first chance to use the man advantage.
Obviously, goals have been hard to come by. Here's the first power play of the game.
Mannheim's got a chance to go to work on the power play here after their penalty expired. And the puck clears the zone. Mannheim's looking to break out. Across the line from center. There's the whistle. Offside is the call. Stopping the play. We haven't even hit the midway mark of the period. Puck is shot. Play resumes. Raum is moving it along the wing. Lukos got the puck along the wall. Great defensive effort with the stick. Slides it across. Puts the puck on net. That's blocked. And they get the puck out of harm's way. The Eagles scoop it up along the boards. Dahls has the puck against the half wall. Cutting to the front of the net. Stopped by the goaltender.
And he came out and challenged him. Good save.
Some pushing and shoving here, heating up.
Yeah, the few words lead to a little bit more, it looks like. Dahls is looking for somebody to engage in a fight with. He can't find the right guy.
Mannheim's moving it into the offensive end. Takes a shot, and there's the save. Scoops up the puck here. Now into the offensive zone from the right side. Mannheim's got a hold of it along the wall. Right up the gut into the attacking zone. Sends it across. Hammers a shot. What a stop. Referee's hand shoots high in the air. Looks like we got a tripping penalty coming up. Time for the official to pass down his sentence. Schutz is going off for 2 minutes.
Pretty easy call for the referee to make as you're fishing around for the puck. He's focused in on the play, and when the player goes down, his hand will go out.
Shots, 2 minutes for tripping. Time of the penalty, 10 minutes, 11 seconds.
From his own end, he moves it up ahead. Puts it on net and makes the save. Slides the puck over. Raum has gained possession along the boards.
Upstart for step
off the crossbar. Raum has got it in their own zone. Up along the wall on the right side and into the attacking area. Drives to the paint. Stones him in front. Solid hit on the play, and that knocks the puck off his stick. Takes the feed. Moves the puck. Turns it away. The Eagles will play it in their own end. And the power play comes up empty. Both teams back to even strength.
Really aggressive work by the penalty killers. They shut that power play down without any danger.
And he connects with the long bomb. Nice stick work to knock the puck loose. And he's going after him here.
Oh, the athletic therapist is already...
They're going to go.
Yeah, he jumped in pretty quickly after his teammate got hurt. He wants to defend here.
Oh, and he caught him right there, and that'll pretty much do it.
Yeah, that's not going to go to the judges. They'll untangle. That's the end of the fight. That's also the end of the night. You fight, you're gone. See you later, boys.
Yeah, a little throwdown, a little showdown, and they piece themselves out of this one.
Mannheim's got another opportunity here on the man advantage.
Mannheim penalty, number 97. A 5-minute major for fighting and a game misconduct.
There's the horn bringing period number one to an end. Still no score in this one. Both teams are back at center ice, and we are ready to get period number two underway. Raumann's shorthanded unit has done a solid job to this point. Just a few more seconds to spare as they win the draw. Tries to feed it across. And they are ready to drop the puck on period number three. Raumann's penalty killers have their work cut out for them here. But a nice start to the period as they win the draw. Just wide! The Eagles played along the boards. And as both teams are now back at even strength, the power play goes 0-for on the opportunity.
Well, the penalty killers can go back to the bench knowing they did their job. Score remains the same as it was when that penalty was taken.
James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro with you here in the early going of this period. Raumann's got a hold of the puck. Lukko's got it in their own zone. The Eagles ready to go on the attack. Takes a shot. Oh, you can't miss that.
Now, somehow I got 408, James. You don't get any of
it. Scores!
Two, score a goal, make a change, get another one. Nothing seems to slow them down.
Mannheim's been a dominant force offensively. Plenty of quality scoring opportunities, and they lead it big time early in the third. This neutral zone faceoff set to go, and we are back underway. Passes right to the front. Scores! Wow, this is unbelievable.
Four straight goals. They've dominated this play. That's a scorer's goal right there. That puck is on and off his stick in a hurry. He's so tight to the net, he has to get rid of it before the goalie can readjust.
The Eagles have been the more active squad offensively tonight, and they lead it early in this third period. Mannheim's won the draw in the neutral zone. The Eagles looking against the half wall. Centering pass! Scores!
A quick flick of the wrist and that snapshot beats the goaltender. He's in the low slot. He doesn't have much time to think about it.
Puck possession, so critical. Another faceoff coming up here.
The Eagles win it. Here's a chance to make something happen inside the neutral zone. From the right side and up the middle. No room for that one to get through.
2 minutes, 59 seconds.
Once said to me many years ago, show me a good coach, I'll show you a good goalie. There was a good one tonight.
Yeah, the team looks good, and the goalie was great. The win that comes on the heels of a solid defensive performance. But when your goalie throws an egg up, it makes everybody look good.
Two sets of Warriors lining up. These guys pushed each other.
Exhausted, tired. At the end of any long frame series, you are gassed. But one team gets to it.
We are far from done from this tournament. For Ray Ferraro, my name is James Cebulski. We'll see you at the next game. Good night.